Today we are gonna cover the topic of matrix multiplication, okay, on a 2D mesh. In a 2D mesh, we say if we multiply the matrix sequentially, okay, in the sequential multiplication, if A is also, if there are two matrices A and B and we are multiplying them to generate the product matrix, that is C, and we say that both A and B are of dimension n cross n, okay. So what are the dimensions of the product matrix C? Bolo, what are the dimensions of product matrix C? Both A and B are of dimension A, n cross n. N cross n. Fine. And if I ask you that what are the number of multiplications which are indulged in generating the product matrix? If there are n square values in the product matrix C, then in generating each of the values, how many multiplications have been performed? For each of the n square values, how many multiplications have been performed? N. Okay? N are the multiplications which have been performed in generating each of the n square values. It means that making a total number of multiplications equal to? There are a n square values and each of the values has been computed by computing n multiplication, making a total of n cube multiplications. Okay? So we can say that sequentially, executing the concept of multiplying the two matrices has the time complexity of n cube. Fine. Now our goal is to embed parallelism in the task of multiplying two matrices. Okay. The systems are arranged in the form of a 2D mesh and we are assuming that both A and B are square matrices. This is our assumption. Okay, that A is also n cross n and B is also n cross n. And the parallel system, in the parallel system, the processes are also arranged in the form of a 2D mesh whose dimensions are also n cross n. Fine. Now, the example which we are taking up, both the matrices A and B are of dimensions 4 cross 4. Fine? Okay. Now there are 16 cells. Okay. Each of the cell is having a processor which is supposed to multiply the two values which it is holding. Okay. Now if we multiply the two matrices, we know that the value which we are taking up from the matrix A, if it is lying in the jth column, then the value with which we are multiplying it with in the matrix B, the row number of the figure of matrix B should be in the jth row, right? Theek hai na? If I say that the product matrix is C, what will be C00? What is C00? First row of A are multiplied with the first column of B. Theek hai? So it means A00 will be multiplied with B00. Theek hai? Next value in the first row in case of A What will be that? 0, 1. And the next value in the first column of B will be B, 1, 0. Fine. Next, what will be the figure? 0, 2 into B, 2, 0 and plus 0, 3 into B, 3, 0. Now, if you have a look, the second parameter of A is matching with the first parameter of B. Okay? Now, in this case, how many cells out of 16 are satisfying this criteria? Out of 16 values, how many are satisfying the criteria that the second parameter of A is matching with the first parameter of B? Okay? If you look, only the diagonal ones, that is the right diagonal, four values along the right diagonal are satisfying the value that the column number of A is matching with the row number of B. Okay? If n square processes have been indulged, that is in this example, there are 16 processes. Okay? If 16 processes are doing this job, then only the task of 4 processes is meaningful. Okay? All other processes task, if they multiply, for example, I have the processor P03 over here. Okay? If the processor P03 is lying over here, though it can multiply, but the multiplication will be useless, right? Because these values 03 and 03 are not required to be multiplied to find out the product matrix C. Are you able to understand? Okay. Now what we will do? We will be shifting the values of A row wise and the values of B column wise. Okay. The values of row are being represented by the variable I and the values of column are being represented by the variable j. Okay? And numbering has started from 0. Okay? Now what we shall be doing is that each row will be shifted I places to the left. Fine? Each row of matrix A will be shifted I places to the left, and regarding the matrix B, fine. Okay, that the values of A will be replaced row wise and the values of B will be replaced column wise. Okay? And the number of positions according to which they have to be shifted, that will vary row wise in case of A and column wise in case of B. Okay? Proceeding with matrix A, if we talk about matrix A, what is the value of I for the first row? What is the value of I for the first row in case of a matrix A? 0. Okay? Now, if the value of I is 0, then how many places it has to be shifted to the left? 0 positions. Okay? It means first row of A will be shifted 0 positions. To conclude, we can say that it will not be replaced. Okay? It will occupy its original position only. Fine. Now coming up to the second row. What is the value of I for the second row? 1. Okay. For the second row of A, we can say that since I is equal to 1, and so it means how many places it has to be shifted to the left? By 1. Okay. Now it has to be shifted to 1. So it means we can say that 1, 0 will come up over here. Okay. Similarly, 1, 1 will be replacing 1, 0. Fine. Proceeding in the same manner, this will be the scenario. Fine. Coming up to the third row, what is the value of I for the third row of A? 2. It means how many places it has to be shifted to the left? 2 places. Okay. It means A20, A21, A22, and A23. Fine. Coming up to the last row of A, what is the value of I for the same? 3. It means it has to be shifted 3 positions to the left. Fine? Fine. Now coming up to matrix B, how we shall be proceeding in case of matrix B? Column wise. Okay? And if the column number is J, then the column B will, column of matrix B will be shifted J positions upward direction. Fine? So it means for the first column of B, what is the value of J? 0. It means how many positions it will be shifted upwards? 0. Fine? 0, 0. Fine. Now, coming up to the second column. What is the value of J for the second column? 1. It means it shall be shifted by one position in the upward direction. Okay? So it means B01 shall be moving here. Fine. B11. Fine. Okay, coming up, similarly proceeding in the same manner for the third column and the fourth column. What will be the scenario? Fine. Okay, now similarly for the third column as well. Okay, fine. Now, the values which have been moved outside the matrix, they are cyclically rotated. Okay, they are rotated and made to enter again into the matrix. So, what will happen? This A10 will be rotated and will be made to place over here. Fine. Okay, this A20, what will happen? By one position, when it was moved, it will come over here. By two positions when it was moved, this will come over here. Fine. Similarly, A21, where will A21 be placed when it is made to enter into the matrix? In the last column. Theek hai na, last column mein aa gaya wo. Theek hai? And talking about the last row of matrix A, this will be A30, this will be A31, and this will be A32. Fine. Now talking about the matrix B, what will happen? Fine. Theek hai? Right? Theek hai? Fine. Okay. Now if you look at all the 16 cells, all the 16 cells are containing the values of A and B in such a way that the column number of A is matching with the row number of B. Okay. In all the 16 cells. It means all the values are valid for multiplication. Okay. Now all the 16 processors which are induced in the multiplication, each of the processors will be multiplying the values of A and B which it is holding. Okay? Now if I denote the product matrix by C, that is the matrix C is equal to A cross B. Okay? Now if I have to compute Cij, how many multiplications this each of the Cij values will be holding? In order to compute the value, each of the values of Cij, in this example I say each of the 16 values of C, how many multiplications are required to be done? Okay, na? Because A is also 4 cross 4, B is also 4 cross 4. So it means matrix C will also be of dimension 4 cross 4. There will be 16 values, and to compute each of the 16 values, there will be 4 multiplications. Okay? There will be 4 multiplications, and as of now, how many multiplications have been done? How many multiplications have been executed as of now. For example, if I talk about C00, okay? C00, where will it be placed? In the top left corner, okay? And in the top left corner, which is the multiplication which has been done in the first step? The point where we are at the current time. How many multiplications have been done to calculate C00? Only one. Okay? Only one multiplication has been done. Okay? If I say what will be the value of C00? A00 cross B00. Fine. Plus A01 into B10. Okay? Similarly, A02 cross B20. And A03 cross B30. Fine. Now, out of these four products, out of these four multiplications which are indulged in finding the value of C00, how many multiplications have been executed as of now? How many multiplications have been executed as of now? Only one. Okay? Only one multiplication has been done, that is A00 has been multiplied with B00. Okay? My next task is two values will be displaced in such a way that in the next step, these two values will be placed in same cell. Okay? These two values will be placed in same cell, and in the next step, all the n square processors will again multiply the values of A and B which they are holding. Okay? Now how? If I say A00 is over here and B00 is over here, which is the next value of A which is required? 01. Fine. And what is the value of B which is required? 10. Okay? Now if I have a look at A01, where is A01? To the right of the cell. Okay, A01 is to the right of the cell where C00 is being computed. Okay, similarly, the next value of B, that is B10, where is it placed as of now? Just search it out, B10, where is it lying as of now? Here it is lying. Okay, so my next step's goal is to make A01 and B10 meet in this cell. Fine. Why? Because they will be multiplied and their product will be included in the figure C00. Fine. Are you understanding the concept? Okay. A01 is the next value and B10 is the next value. It means what is going to happen in the next step? After multiplying these two figures, we shall be shifting each row of A, row wise, one position to the left. Okay? Each row of A will be shifted one position to the left, and the values of B will be shifted column wise, and the number of shifts will be same in this step now. The number of shifts for the first row will be one to the left, number of shifts for the second row will be one to the left, number of shifts for the third row will also be same. And the number of shifts for the fourth row will also be same. And hai kitni? How many? Bolo, how many? One. One position to the left. Okay? Similarly, talking about B. Talking about B, what will happen? How we are going to displace the values of matrix B in order to execute the next step for finding out the product matrix C? जैसे हमने A को रो वाइज शफल किया है टू द लेफ्ट, हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्प्लेस द वैल्यूज ऑफ B टू फाइंड आउट द प्रोडक्ट मैट्रिक्स? बोलो कौन सी वैल्यू लेके आनी है यहाँ पे? अब हमने विच वैल्यू हैज टू बी ब्रॉट ओवर है? B10. ठीक है, इन ऑर्डर टू ब्रिंग B10 ओवर है, ठीक है, वॉट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट? इट मीन्स द कॉलम विल बी मूव्ड, ठीक है, वन पोजीशन इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. ठीक है, इन केस ऑफ बी द मूवमेंट विल बी मेड कॉलम वाइज एंड ईच कॉलम विल बी शिफ्टेड बाय वन पोजीशन टू द इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. ठीक है. इफ आई टेक अबाउट फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई टेक अबाउट सी वन टू, ठीक है. वॉट इज सी वन टू? फाइन, ठीक है. फाइन, ठीक है ना. सॉरी, फाइन, ठीक है. नाउ वेर इज सी वन टू लाइन? वेर इज सी वन टू? हेयर इट इज, ठीक है. नाउ इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप विच मल्टीप्लीकेशन हैज बीन मेड? विच मल्टीप्लीकेशन हैज बीन मेड? One of the multiplication has been made in the first step. ठीक है, actually this matrix is the original one. ठीक है, this step which we shall be making up, that will be referring the second matrix. ठीक है, in which the values were written after shifting them, after shifting each of the rows I position to the left and each of the columns J positions upwards. ठीक है, fine. Now C12 is I is equal to 1 and J equal to 2. After replacement, what is the second row? How are the values of second row lying? Fine? ठीक है. ठीक है, करंटली व्हाट वी हैव डन इज वी हैव मेड द मल्टीप्लीकेशन, दिस मल्टीप्लीकेशन, दीज टू वैल्यूज आर लाइंग ओवर, लाइंग इन द सेल. ये दोनों वैल्यूज आफ्टर मूवमेंट, दीज टू आर बीइंग मेड टू मीट इन द सेम सेल. ठीक है, दिस इज द सेकेंड रो, ठीक है, ऑफ ए एंड दिस इज द थर्ड कॉलम ऑफ बी. ठीक है, दीज वैल्यूज विच आर लाइंग इन द सेम सेल हैव बीन मल्टीप्लाइड in the first step itself. Okay, what has happened in the first step? These values have been multiplied. Okay, now after which, what we are gonna do? We shall be replacing, we shall be moving the values of A, B in the upward direction. Okay, similarly the values of A will be moved to the left direction, cyclically again. Okay, jab cyclically move hua, okay, this is the cell where C12 is being computed. यहाँ पे मेरा C12 calculate हो रहा है. ठीक है, C12 में currently मेरे पास कौन कौन सी values मिली हुई है, which are the values which are lying together currently? A13 and B32. This multiplication has been done in the first step itself. ठीक है, this one. ठीक है, now other three multiplications are pending. ठीक है, इनको करने के लिए what we are gonna do? We shall be shifting the values of A row wise, ठीक है, एंड वी शैल बी शिफ्टिंग द वैल्यूज ऑफ बी कॉलम वाइज. ठीक है, रो वाइज टू द लेफ्ट एंड कॉलम वाइज इन द अपवर्ड डायरेक्शन. ठीक है, तो इट मीन्स इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप दीज टू वैल्यूज हैव बीन मूव्ड. ये दोनों मूव हो गई, दोनों एक ही सेल में पड़ी है, दोनों मल्टीप्लाई हो गई. अब बाकी हाउ मेनी प्रोडक्ट आर पेंडिंग टू बी इंक्लूडेड इन द प्रोडक्ट मैट्रिक्स फिगर C12? थ्री वैल्यूज. ठीक है, थ्री वैल्यूज, थ्री प्रोडक्ट्स आर पेंडिंग टू बी इंक्लूडेड इन C12 येट. ठीक है, सो व्हाट वी आर गोना डू इन दिस सेल, द वैल्यूज ऑफ बी, दिस कॉलम will be shifted cyclically in the upward direction. Okay? So it means which value will of B will come into picture in this cell now? B02. Okay? 02 will be coming over here. Okay? That is this one. Okay? And which value of A will be coming into picture? 10, because it has to be shifted to the left. Okay? So is cell mein kya hoga? A10 will come over here. Okay? And 02 will come over here. Okay? 10 and 02 again will be coming up in this cell where C12 is being computed. Now again, this value, these two values will be multiplied and the figure of this product will be included, that is, will be added to the previous product. Previous product also 13 and 32. Okay, na? So again, what will happen? Ab kya ho gaya? Now what is the scenario? What is the scenario now? This figure has been included. Similarly, this figure has also been included in C12. Okay? So those steps mere aur hoenge in which B will be shifted in the upward direction and A will be shifted left direction so that the values of A and B will be again multiplied and will be added to the value of C12. Okay? I'm giving you an example in which we shall be giving two matrices 3 cross 3. A is also 3 cross 3, B is also 3 cross 3. Okay? We shall be solving that example. Fine? This is A, this is B, and we have to compute the 3 cross 3 product matrix. Okay? Pehle kya karo? What do we do first? The matrix A, the values of matrix A will be relocated row wise, and the values of matrix B will be relocated column wise. Okay? Now, if I place the values after replacement, talking about the first row of A, how many positions it has to be moved? 0. Okay? First row of A will be moved I times, that is 0 times. Okay? So what is the, it means 1, 2, 1. That is the first row will not be moved. Okay? Talking about the second row of A, what is the value of I for the same? Hello? What is the value of I for the same? 1. It means how many positions it shall be shifted? By 1 to the which direction? Left. Okay, it means what will be the order? 1, 4, 3. Now tell me about the third row of A. 5, 2 and 9. Okay, 5, 2 and 9. Now talking about the B matrix, we shall be proceeding column wise. Okay, talking about the first column, what is the value of J for the same? 0. It means it will be shifted by 0 positions. Okay? 0 position says they will be lying at the same position. This would be the scenario. Okay? Coming up to the second column. What is the value of J for the second column? 1. Okay? Now if the value of J for the second column is 1, it means 3 will be coming here, 2 will be coming here, and 4 will be going there. Fine? Okay? Now coming up to the third column. बोलो क्या है की वैल्यू फाइन ठीक है नाउ द फर्स्ट स्टेप व्हाट विल हैपन इन द फर्स्ट स्टेप व्हेन वी शैल बी कंप्यूटिंग द वैल्यूज ऑफ सी वी शैल बी फाइंडिंग द प्रोडक्ट वी शैल बी मल्टीप्लाइंग ईच ऑफ द वैल्यूज विच ईच ऑफ द 9 सेल्स इज होल्डिंग ठीक है वन ऑफ द वैल्यूज ऑफ ए एंड अदर वैल्यू ऑफ बी बोथ वी शैल बी मल्टीप्लाइंग इन ऑल द 9 ठीक है एंड द प्रोडक्ट मैट्रिक्स सी विल बी इंक्लूडिंग 2, 6, 7, 1, 8, 18, 35, 8 and 81. Fine. ठीक है. Now, how many multiplications have been included in each of the figures of product matrix C? One multiplication. ठीक है. One multiplication has been included in each of the 9 values of the product matrix C. Now, what would be my next step? Now, we shall be shifting each row of A, how many positions? 1. In which direction? Left. Similarly, regarding B, how the values will be replaced? By one position, in which direction? Upward direction. ठीक है? Now, writing. What will be the first row of A? ठीक है. 2, 1, 1. First row. Second row of A. B. We shall be proceeding column wise. ठीक है. Talking about first column. 172. Fine. Talking about the second column. 5. ठीक है. थर्ड कॉलम. 5. ठीक है. नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन? ईच ऑफ द सेल्स विल अगेन मल्टीप्लाई द वैल्यूज ऑफ ए एंड बी विच इट इज होल्डिंग एंड द प्रोडक्ट विल बी एडेड टू द ओरिजिनल वैल्यूज ऑफ सी. ठीक है. Fine. Getting the scenario? ठीक है. One more step will be occurring. ठीक है. One more step would be executed. So what will happen in the third step? How will these values be relocated? Talking about matrix A, first column, first row, sorry. First row, बोलो. 1, 1, 2. Second row. 3, 1, 4 and third row. 5. ठीक है. Now coming up to matrix B and proceeding in the column wise order. Fine. ठीक है. Talking about the second column. ठीक है. And talking about the third column. Fine. ठीक है. Now what has happened? Each of the values of matrix, both matrices A and B, have been relocated to find out the third figure which has to be included in each of the 9 figures of the product matrix. ठीक है. Fine. ठीक है. Now each of the values, all the values, when they will be added, it will be forming the product matrix Cij whose dimensions are 3×3. ठीक है. Now we shall be doing the algo of the same. ठीक है. Algo देखो. Algo says, this is the first phase. First phase mein, what is my goal in the first phase? What is my goal in the first phase? To shift the values of A row wise and B column wise so that each cell contains the values which are valid for multiplication for finding out the product matrix C. Fine. Now, if we talk about the first row, first row was shifted how many times? 0. ठीक है. Second row was shifted one time and third row was shifted two times. What was the value of I for the same? 0, 1, 2. Okay, it means what is happening? Each of the row is shifted I times to the left in the cyclic manner. Okay? First row is not shifted. Okay, first row is not shifted. It means we have started the counter from 1. Okay, even if we include 0, that will also not make any difference. Okay, but here we have written 1 which says that the shifting has to start from the I equal to 1, that is the second row, okay, for which I is equal to 1. Okay, to the last row, whose value of I is equal to n minus 1. This figure K is for both row and column. Okay, now for I between 1 and n minus 1, what we are doing, if I is greater than K, for example, what we say that in the first cycle, what is the value of K? What is the value of K when this loop is executed for the first time? 1. Okay? Now K is equal to 1. Which row is satisfying the criteria that I is greater than K? Which values of I are satisfying this criteria? I greater than K. Which rows are satisfying this criteria? It says that the second row is satisfying the criteria for which I is equal to 1. Now if I greater than equal to K, K is equal to, what is the value of K presently? 1. And which values of I are satisfying the criteria that I greater than equal to K? 1 and 2. Okay? It means which rows are, A is being replaced by the value to its right. Okay? This is east of A. A is being replaced by east of A. It means which shift is occurring? Left shift. Okay? If A is being replaced by the value on its east, it means the left shift is occurring in the row. Okay? Left shift says that when this loop is executing for I is equal to 1, okay, when it is executing for I equal to 1, then the second and third rows will be shifted to the left. Okay? Similarly, when J is greater than equal to K, what is the value of K currently? 1. Okay? Value of K is 1 currently. And for J, which column will be shifted in the upward direction? Now what is happening? Each value of B is shifted by the value to its south. South means in the downward direction. Okay? Each value is being shifted by the value which is lying below it. Okay? It means which rotation is happening in the column of B? Upward direction. Okay? It means which, if K's value is 1, then which column, which value of J is satisfying this criteria that J greater than equal to K? Bolo, which columns, which values of J are satisfying this criteria? That J is greater than equal to K. 1 and 2. Okay? J is equal to 1, it is greater than equal to K. Okay? And J equal to 2, it is satisfying the criteria that it is greater than equal to 1. It means when this loop executed for K equal to 1. Okay? When this loop executed for K equal to 1. Which row shifted to the left? Second and third row. Okay, second and third row shifted to the left when it executed for K equal to 1. Because for second row, I equal to 1, and for third row, I equal to 2. Similarly, for K equal to 1, when the movement was applied column wise, okay, when the movement was applied column wise, then which values of J satisfied this criteria? J greater than equal to K? 1 and 2. Okay, J equal to 1 satisfied the criteria of greater than equal to 1, and J equal to 2 satisfied the criteria of greater than equal to 1. Okay, it means J equal to 1 and 2. It means second and third column. Okay, second and third column shifted. Okay, now what would happen? This for loop would again get executed. For loop which is regarding K. Okay, pehle mera jo execute hua tha, wo in that case, what was the value of K? 1. Okay, what is the value of the example which we discussed? In the example, what was the value of n? 3. It means if the value of n was 3, k will be executed for 1 and 2. Okay, when it was executed for 1, these shufflings were made, and when it will be executed for 2, when k will come out to be equal to 2, then this condition that I greater than equal to k, which value of I is satisfying this criteria of greater than equal to 2? Bolo, which value of I? Only I equal to 2 is satisfying the criteria. Only I equal to 2 is satisfying the criteria. It means only the third row. Okay? It means when it executed for k equal to 2, only third row was shifted. When it executed for k equal to 1, both second and third row were shifted. Okay? It means overall, how many times second row got shifted? Bolo, when it executed for k equal to 1, both second and third row got shifted. When it executed for k equal to 2, only the third row for which I equal to 2, it got shifted. Okay? It means how many times second row has overall got shifted? Second row. Second row is coming up only once. And third row is occurring twice. Okay? It means third row was shifted 2 times and the first row was shifted 1 time only. Okay? Second row for which I equal to 1. Okay? Similarly, proceeding to the column wise, same is the column wise, that is for k equal to 1, j equal to 1 and j equal to 2, that is the second column and the third column, were rotated, and when it will execute for k equal to 2, which value of j will be satisfying the criteria of greater than equal to k? So which the condition, which j will be satisfying the criteria that j greater than equal to k, whose current value is 2? Bolo, j equal to 2. Okay, j equal to 2 will satisfy this criteria. It means for j equal to 1, shifting has occurred once. Okay, similarly for j equal to 2, shifting has occurred twice. Okay, it means second column has shifted once and third column has shifted twice. Okay, so it means till here what has happened? All the values are rotated, and in all the n square cells, the values have been replaced in such a way that all n square cells are containing the valid values for multiplication for generating the product matrix C. Now, this goal, this step, what is these doing? These are multiplying both. Now, my next phase starts, in which we are, my first phase, that the values which are occurring after these movements, they will be multiplied. Each of the n square processors, what each of the n square processors will do, it will multiply its value with its value of b, and the product will be included in the variable c. Okay? All the processors are doing this job. Since all the processors are doing this job, so we say for all the values of I and j lying between 0 and n minus 1, okay, all the values of I and j, it means it is all the n square processors. All the n square processors are multiplying the values of a which is holding, it is holding, and the value of b which it is holding with and including it into the variable c. Okay? Now this step says that now how many product values have been included in the variable c? C mein abhi tak kitni product values include ho chuki hain? Only 1. 2 are pending yet. Okay? Ab 2 are pending yet, for which we are taking up a loop of a. Okay, up n is equal to 3. Okay, 2 values are pending yet. So this for loop of k will be running from 1 to 2. Because 2 product values have yet to be included in each of the Cij values. Okay, so for k equal to 1 to 2, now what we are going to do? We shall be replacing each value of a with the value to its east. Okay, that is each row is shifted left by 1 position. Similarly, each of the values of b is replaced by the value to its south. It means each column is shifted one position in the upward direction. Okay, now after movement, again each of the n square cells are including the valid values for multiplication, for including them in each of the Cij values of the product matrix C. Okay, now again what we shall be doing, these new values of A and B will again be multiplied by each of the n square processors, and the original value of C will be added to it, and the new value of C will be generated. ठीक है, अब मेरा दूसरी वैल्यू इंक्लूड हो गई, दूसरा प्रोडक्ट इंक्लूड हो गया ईच ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट वैल्यूज में, सिंस अभी तीसरा पेंडिंग है. ठीक है, दिस वॉज फॉर k इक्वल टू 1, नाउ अगेन इट विल बी एग्जीक्यूटिंग फॉर k इक्वल टू 2. व्हेन इट विल बी एग्जीक्यूटिंग फॉर k इक्वल टू 2, द सेकंड थर्ड प्रोडक्ट वैल्यू विल बी इंक्लूडेड इन ईच ऑफ द फिगर्स, एंड ईच ऑफ द फिगर इज नाउ फाइनल विद द प्रोडक्ट वैल्यू ऑफ मैट्रिक्स ए एंड बी. ठीक है, फाइन. Now if I talk about the complexity, what is the complexity of the same? In the first step, what was the case? If the dimensions of the matrix are n cross n, if the dimension of matrix A is also n cross n, and the matrix dimension B is also n cross n, okay? In the first step,